Hi, and welcome to this How Do I video about adding a custom control to a Dynamics 365 extension. At the end of this video, you will know how to create a JavaScript controller in and add it to a Dynamics 365 page. We will do that by following these steps. First, we will create a JavaScript control add-in. Then the control add-in will be added to a page. After that, we add the integration between AL code and JavaScript code by invoking AL code from the control add-in and the other way around, calling JavaScript code from AL code. So let's switch to Visual Studio Code now and start with creating the control add-in. We will create a Bing Maps control for the customer card. For more information how to create and initialize a workspace, see one of the other videos in this series. We start with creating a new folder. This folder will contain the files that belong to the JavaScript control add-in. This is not necessary but recommended to keep it organized. Inside the folder, we create a new file and call it Bing Maps Control. In this file, we specify the object control add-in and the name of the control. A custom control add-in depends on JavaScript. The first property we specify is what scripts we want to include. We can include local scripts from our extension as well as scripts from other locations. This is the script that holds the Bing Maps functionality. You don't forget to fill in your own Bing Maps key. To initialize the control add-in, we need a script that is automatically executed when the control add-in has been loaded. We create a new file called startup script, and inside this file, we write the code to initialize the control add-in. An element with the ID control add-in is automatically added to the page. We just have to find it and fill it with data. Back to the control add-in, we specify the startup script, which is a local script file for the extension. We always specify a location that is relative to the root folder of the extension. We are now ready to add this control to a page. First, we remove the Hello World example. The map will be displayed in the Factbox area, for which we create a new object of type CardPart. The CardPart will be based on the customer table. In the layout of the page, we have the content area in which we define a user control. This user control then uses the Bing Maps control that we have created earlier. The property application area is needed, otherwise the control will not be visible in Dynamics 365. The next step is to add the Factbox to the customer card. We do that by creating a page extension for the customer card page. In the layout of the page extension, we go to the Factboxes area, in which we add the card part as the first Factbox. Again, the application area property is needed to make this visible in Dynamics 365. The customer card page and the Bing Maps control page are linked together by the customer number. Let's test the result. We publish the extension to Dynamics 365, and then we open the customer card. As you can see, the Bing Maps control is displayed. However, the size is not exactly what we want it to be. So let's go back to the user control and specify the height and width. For this, we have multiple properties like requested minimum and maximum height and width. And we can also specify if the control is allowed to grow or shrink. Let's again open the customer card and see the result. The map is now displayed with the correct size. The next step is to pass the correct address of the displayed customer. For this, we need interaction between AL code and JavaScript code. The first step is to tell the AL code that a control add-in is ready to receive data. To invoke AL code, we specify an event. To raise this event from the control add-in, we add a line of JavaScript code to the script file, which calls the invoke extensibility method. Inside AL code, we create a trigger that is linked to the event of the user control. In this case, we only set a global variable, which we will use in the next step. To call JavaScript code from AL code, we first need to create a JavaScript function. We do that in a new JavaScript file. Here we have created a function showAddress that accepts an address parameter and which uses the Bing Maps Search Manager to find and display the address on the map. We need to add this script to the script's property of the control add-in. Then we declare the showAddress function as a function that can be called from AL code. Back in AL code, we add a function that first checks if the control add-in is ready to receive calls. Then it composes the address to search for, and finally it calls a JavaScript function showAddress on the user control. The final step is to call this function from the control add-in ready function and from the onAfterGetRecord trigger. This is a trigger that occurs when a new record is loaded in the page. Let's publish this again and check the results on Dynamics 365. The map is now showing the correct address and it changes when we navigate to the next customer record. So, in this video, we first started with creating a control add-in. We have added a control add-in to the customer page by means of a fact box. Then we invoked AL code from JavaScript code and we called JavaScript code from AL code. So in this video, we have learned how to create a user control, how to create a page and a page extension and add a fact box, and how to integrate AL code with JavaScript. For further information, we refer you to the link displayed on the screen.